Teachers groups in the Philippines divided over the push for a full resumption of face-to-face classes by August this year. Some point out the government has yet to roll out enough safety measures in schools. Ara Perez reports.
Kinder students in Pasig Elementary School can't contain their joy because despite the pandemic, they were able to return to face-to-face classes and then also take part in in-person moving up ceremony, unlike some of their peers who had to make do with online classes.
Medyo challenging po, pero at the same time, rewarding din po kasi nairaos namin yung buong 2 years.
Ano pa? Tulad ko po magbasa at magsulat at magdance.
Teachers say this stage in a learner's journey is critical because a strong foundation at this point will greatly help them once they move to elementary education.
Mas marami pong natutong magbasa kasi syempre yung mga materials po na ginamit po namin na pinasa namin sa mga magulang. Mas ano po kasi yung bonding ng mga magulang sa mga anak nila pag may mga ganun na magbabasa, story time.
After joining the pilot face-to-face classes in NCR last December and the expansion phase in February, Pasig Elementary School is ready for the full implementation of face-to-face classes next school year. Modules and online classes will still be used and health protocols will remain, especially physical distancing.
Halimbawa, 4,000 pupils namin, meron kami set A and set B. So halimbawa, yung set A na pupils namin, Monday, narito siya. Ang set B naman namin ay Tuesday. And then Wednesday, all children synchronous, meaning it may be virtual, wherein imi-meet sila ng mga teachers nila. And then Thursday ay set A na naman ay face-to-face, and then set B, sila din naman ng face-to-face. So in short, our children, no, they will be meeting their children, their teachers, at least 3 times. They will all experience face-to-face classes.
Based on data from DepEd, over 33,000 schools are offering face-to-face classes. But DepEd notes all schools must be prepared to implement in-person classes in the next school year. And for schools located in areas under Alert Level 1, more students will now be allowed back since physical distancing rules are expected to be eased.
At sa Alert Level 1 ay i-relax na din sa darating na pasukan yung physical distancing requirement. So ngayon kasi ay may limitasyon tayo sa ilang mga mag-aaral ang maaring i-accommodate sa isang silid-aralan para ma-observe yung physical distancing. At itong panahon, itong break na ito ay gugugulin para 100% ay maging handa ang ating mga paaralan. At sa privado naman ay patuloy yung pakipag-ugnayan ng ating private education office para sa mga guidelines na ito.
The Teachers Dignity Coalition is also in favor of bringing back more students to schools.
Hindi ko naman po sinasabing sapat na, no, hindi ko rin sinasabing ligtas na tayo, no, sa August, no, pero ang amin pong gustong i-highlight po dito lahat na po ay nag face-to-face face-to-face yung mga malls, no, yung mga basketball, no, yung mga liga, yung campaign, ano, nung nakarang election, face-to-face na rin po lahat.
The Alliance of Concerned Teachers, however, believes government has not done enough to make schools pandemic resilient. It also calls out government over the lack of classrooms and teachers for the so-called new normal. The current school year will end this June, while school year 2022-2023 will begin in August. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines detects 32 more cases of the Omicron BA.5 subvariant. Of that number, 21 were from Western Visayas, 4 each from Calabarzon and Metro Manila, and 3 from Central Luzon. Most of the patients were fully vaccinated and experienced mild symptoms. 16 of them have been tagged as recovered, while 14 are still under isolation. The situation of the other 2 patients are still being verified. The Philippines has so far recorded 43 cases of this Omicron subvariant.
The Okta Research Group believes the Philippines should manage the ongoing increase in COVID cases, or what it calls a weak surge, under Alert Level 1. Okta Research Fellow Guido David says, in light of the country's current economic situation, government should not escalate COVID restrictions yet. On Tuesday, the Philippines logged 409 fresh infections, pushing active cases to its highest since May 3rd.
At this time, considering the rising fuel prices, inflation, and all these challenges economically, and considering that there's only going to be a few severe cases based on our experience with Omicron, our position as a group is that we maintain alert level one. Mm-hmm. And it's not saying that, there's no threat. I mean, but considering the other, factors, economics and everything, we think that we should try to manage this under alert level one.